morning po sa lahat ng mga criminology students, sa mga graduates natin who will be taking the criminology licensure examination. Welcome po. Welcome sa BQueno Online. Ito po ang platform natin sa lahat ng rationalizations na gagawin po natin sa 6 major areas. Ang target po is yung mga questions who came out in the previous board examination. So I hope po, ma-share nyo po ang videos po natin, lahat ng rationalizations po natin para at least po marami ang matulungan. Now, the first question po na lumabas sa board examination, isa po ito sa mga tanong na lumabas sa board examination, ito po. What crime is committed if a person is found loitering into public or semi-public buildings or places, or trampling or wandering about the country or the streets without visible means of support? Now, ang choices mo sa makikita nyo, letter A, prostitution, letter B, pauperism, letter C, vagrancy, or letter D, no crime. So, ang tanong po is, ano po ba ang krimen na makumit ng isang taong palaboy-laboy lang, walang trabaho, no visible means of support, loitering or trampling or wandering about the country or the streets, meaning palaboy-laboy po. Ibig sabihin dyan, ano ang kaso, ano ang criminal liability sa taong palaboy-laboy lang? Sa option letter A, prostitution, that's very clear na hindi po prostitution ang sagot. Kasi ang prostitution po, ito po yung krimen wherein a particular individual will engage on sexual activities for economic benefits. Prostitution po yan. Sa letter B, ibig sabihin ng letter B, pauperism. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng pauperism? Pauperism means yung namamalimos. Tingnan natin sa Article 202 ng Revised Penal Code. Tingnan po natin, RPC po natin, Criminal Law Book 2. May tinatawag po tayong crime na vagrancy. Ang definition po ng vagrancy, ito po yung mga tao na palaboy-laboy basically. So if you will take a look at it, dapat po ang answer natin is vagrancy. Pero ha, sa latest update po natin sa Revised Penal Code, na-amend po ang Article 202. Ha? So, ano ba yung amendment? Ang amendment po sa Article 202 is that yung vagrancy has been removed. Na-removed po siya as the country's list of crime. Ibig sabihin, yung vagrancy po natin ngayon is already decriminalized. So meaning, hindi na po crime ang vagrancy. So balikan po natin ang tanong. Ano po ba ang dapat na answer natin dyan? Ang sagot po is not letter C, but rather letter D. Bakit po letter D? Bakit po no crime? Kasi nga po, yung vagrancy natin ngayon has already been decriminalized. Meaning, hindi na po yan crime. So if a person, nagpalaboy-laboy siya, loitering, trampling, wandering in the streets or buildings without visible means of support, hindi po, wala pong criminal liability. Kasi, again, yung vagrancy po natin has already been decriminalized. Ibig sabihin, hindi na po yan crime. So the answer is, no crime, letter D. Another question that came out in a previous board examination, ito po mga kadete. Evidence of the same kind unto the same state of facts. It is a testimony, repetitive of testimony given earlier. It is additional evidence which merely reinforces testimony previously given. So ano ibig sabihin nito? Isa pong ebidensya na nag-reinforce. Ibig sabihin na nag-reinforce, nag-support sa previous testimony na ibinigay. Isang evidence na nag-support sa previous testimony na binigay. Now, ang choices is letter A, cumulative evidence, letter B, corroborative, letter C, prima facie, letter D, exculpatory evidence. Yung letter C, napaka-isip po niyan, prima facie evidence. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng prima facie? It is an evidence that can stand alone. Bakit nga po? Can stand alone kasi nga po uncontradicted yan eh. Evidence that is uncontradicted. Sufficient po to maintain the proposition affirmed. Yan po, prima facie, uncontradicted that can stand alone. So ang prima facie, hindi po yan sagot. Ang exculpatory evidence naman, ito po yung evidence which will excuse a person from an alleged fault or crime. Ebidensya po na mag-excuse sa tao on a particular alleged fault or an accusation, basically. On the other hand, pag corroborative evidence naman, ibig sabihin, this is an additional evidence that could support the same point, or it's a separate evidence that could support or that could prove a certain or the same point, corroborative. So ibig sabihin, sa tatlo na choices, corroborative, prima facie, exculpatory, hindi po ito ang mga sagot sa tanong. So basically, ang sagot po dyan is letter A, which is cumulative evidence. Isang evidence that could reinforce the testimony previously given. Pangatlong tanong, this is the last cadet. In a way, yung mga additional questions, i-upload ko na lang po. Mas mabuti po pag maiksi. Now, pangatlong tanong that came out in the criminologist licensure examination last April 2023 po. Can a child be qualified to become a witness in court? Ang choices po, letter A, yes. If the child is the only sole witness of a grave crime. Letter B, no, the witness must be 18 years old. Letter C, yes, if the child can perceive, remember, and can distinguish truth from falsehood. Letter D, no, children are psychologically still on the stage of immaturity that may tarnish the integrity of any testimony. Pag sagutin po natin ang tanong in a general sense, ang bata po is not yet 18 years old, so hindi po qualified. Pero, legally speaking po, ang qualification ng witness po nagsasabi na lahat ng tao who are capable of perceiving and can make their own perception to others can be considered as a witness. Ibig sabihin, ang nakalagay po dyan, all persons who can perceive and who can make their known perception to others. Ang tanong ngayon, ang bata ba can be qualified to become a witness? So ang sagot po natin is, yes, as long as the child can perceive, can remember, and can distinguish truth from falsehood. So ano po ba ang sagot natin? Ang sagot po is letter C. Now, follow-up question. How about yung deaf and mute? Okay? Yung deaf and mute, are they qualified to become a witness? The answer again is, on the technical side, yung legal side po natin, pwede po, again, if they can perceive, they can remember, and they can actually communicate. Another question, yung mentally retarded, yung feeble-minded, are they qualified to become a witness? Mentally retarded yan. Feeble-minded, are they qualified? Ang sagot po dyan, sabi ng batas, pwede po, they are qualified as long as they can still give a fairly intelligent and reasonable answer. So long as yung answer po nila or response is fairly intelligent po or reasonable narrative po ang naibigay, nako, pwede po, qualified sila to become a witness. Pero yung mga tao suffering from mental illness, okay? Yung mental illness po, automatic po yan, disqualification po sa isang tao na maging witness sa korte. So ibig sabihin, pag ang tanungan po sa board examination, which of the following is disqualified? Children, deaf, mute, feeble-minded, or mental illness? Ang disqualified po dyan is no other than yung mental illness lang po. Good luck po sa lahat ng magtitake ng criminologist licensure examination. Tiwala sa Diyos at tiwala po sa sarili. God bless you guys.